In this video, we will learn how the Fisher 289 relief valve works through this animation. The 289 is a direct-operated, high-capacity relief valve commonly used in outdoor natural gas relief applications to protect systems from overpressure conditions. The valve is controlled by three essential elements: the spring, which controls the set point of the relief valve, the diaphragm, which measures the pressure of the system, and the elastomer disc, which restricts the gas from passing to the atmosphere until the valve needs to open. As an overpressure event occurs, the inlet pressure, shown in red, begins to apply more force on the diaphragm until it overcomes the spring force to open the valve and vent gas to the atmosphere. The key feature behind the valve's ability to flow large volumes of gas is the pitot tube. As the high-velocity gas flows, an area of low pressure is created at the tip of the pitot tube, which creates a slight vacuum to help suck air out of the spring case. This vacuum effect is key to reducing the required buildup pressure to keep the gas line below the maximum allowable operating pressure. This vacuum increases the differential above and below the diaphragm. As a result, the valve opens more to vent off gas at a higher rate than a similar relief valve without this feature. Once the overpressure event has ended, the 289 will measure a pressure below its set point and will reseat with bubble-tight shutoff to stop venting. We hope that you benefited from this explanation on the operation of the Fisher 289 relief valve. For more information on the Fisher 289, visit us at Emerson.com or contact your local Emerson sales partner. We'll be right back.